All right, guys. Sorry I'm getting late getting this up, but what we're going to do today is we're going to talk about how we fuel both our performance but also our adaptations. And before I start this, it's really important for me to tell you that I have been a member of the Gatorade Sports Science Institute. I am paid and I have a grant from PepsiCo. So again, anything that I say that says, for example, that you should drink Gatorade or that there's something special about that, please take it with a grain of salt. All right, so what are we going to try and do today? Today, what we're going to try and do is we are going to try to, you should be able to, at the end of this series of videos, you should be able to state the ACSM policy on water intake, because hydration is going to be important for performance. When we get too dehydrated and we're losing body mass, there's a small amount of dehydration that improves performance, but over a certain amount of dehydration, we're going to see a decrease in performance. So what's the stated policy on how much water you should take in? You should be able to explain how training and performance are different. This is a key thing because training means you're looking to get better in the future. Performance means you have to be at your best right now. So we do very different things for training and performance, because for performance, we want to be fully fueled. We want to have everything optimally set up. For training, we want to be, we want to increase the metabolic stress as much as we can, because that's going to be the adaptation, the stimulus for us to adapt. All right. So these two things are very, very different. And we need to keep that in mind as we're considering how we're going to fuel on a given day. You'll be able to describe the effect of glycogen on endurance performance. Explain how glycogen affects your hydration levels. You should be able to describe the role of blood flow in supplementation, because this is going to be essential. So if I want to have a supplement that's going to work perfectly and it's going to be the greatest supplement in the world for improving your endurance capacity of that muscle, if I take it while I'm seated and I'm not doing anything, it's not going to get to the muscle I want it to get to. It's going to get to all of your muscles. It's going to get to your liver. It's going to circulate around your body a little bit. But unless you have blood flow to the muscles that you really want it to go to, it's like, sending an email without a to line. So if you want to actually get the supplement to where you want it to go, to the muscles that you care about, you need to put in that address in the to line so that when you send that email, it goes to something and it goes where you want it to go. You'll be able to name one feeding practice that improves endurance performance. You'll be able to explain why glucose and fructose, when combined together, are better for performance than glucose alone. You'll be able to state the optimal amount of protein to improve muscle growth at any age. You'll be able to name the best source of protein and tell me why that's the best source. And you'll be able to provide the molecular mechanism underlying the effect of protein. So all of those things are going to go together to give us a much better sense as to how we want to fuel ourselves for training, for performance, for adaptation. All right, so really, one of the big things that people got into, about 10 years ago, was this conflict of how much water you should drink. And everybody's like, oh, you gotta drink this much water, and everybody has their cup, and you go and you teach, and everybody's got their bottles on the desk, because, oh, dehydration is a horrible thing. Well, we all evolved with this incredible thing called the sense of thirst. And really what's the last few years has shown us is that, yes, if you get dehydrated, greater than 2% loss of body mass, your performance will go down a little bit. But your thirst will be activated before that point comes up. And so the reality is that now what we tell people is simply just drink to thirst, between half a liter and 0.8 liters per hour when you're training. The lower limit there is if you're smaller or if it's a cool day. Well, the higher limit is if you're larger and it's a warm day. Okay, so it's very simple. Don't aggressively try to drink fluids or electrolytes either before exercise or during exercise, because it's not going to make you healthier. It's not going to improve your performance. And in certain cases, if you just drink water, it could actually put you into health risk. Because one of the things that happens is that if you just drink water and you do a long session like a marathon, or you do something else and you're only drinking water, what can happen is your electrolyte levels can go down because you're sweating out salts. but you're only drinking water. And so you can get what's called hyponatremia, low sodium levels. And that low sodium level component is a really life-threatening condition. And so it's really important that when we're training, when we're exercising, when we're performing, that we drink to thirst. And if we're going to be drinking a large volume of liquid, that we have some sort of electrolyte within the liquid.